Welcome to Qimen Dunjia. My name is Dr. Xuan. Today we're going to have this case study related to this Mr. Marcus who wants to invest in a retail shop and wants to check if this is a good choice. So in Qimen Dunjia, we will actually use the particular date whereby the person asks the time itself, the exact time that they ask, and we plot a chart, and this is the chart which we have divided into two sets for easy references. So this is a chart which is based on 2011, June the 9th, and apparently what happened is that we will can able to see based on this chart to predict what will likely to be a good choice or not a good choice. Okay, so let's go and do step by step on deciphering this information. Okay, so to learn how to use Qimen Dunjia, we need to know where to find the answer first. The answer, when we talk about this particular case, we will have to take reference in terms of this hour stamp. This hour stamp itself is over at this number. HR stands for hour, and this Chinese symbol stands for kui. Kui. So we have to look at in the nine boxes below, where is the kui? Kui is over here. Okay, so in this aspect, we can say that box number nine is the general answer for that. So we have this nine heaven. We know that means a stand for very high expectation, very high ground. So in terms of the answers, we can also see that there's a view. View meaning that there's a contract involved, there's a documentation. We need to look at the details. And problem, we have an interesting problem over here, meaning that the answer of this investing in this particular retail shop may have a problem. And this problem, if I would combine with this nine heaven, mean that the problem can be a lot of problem. Okay, so we really have to look at the details and the contract. Okay, so next we need to look at the asker itself. The asker is over here, which is called the E. That means the person involved, which is Mr. Marcus. He is over here. Okay, he's over here also. So the person himself represent number nine, the box number nine, and the answer is also box number nine. So we also take reference on that particular thing in this symbol. That means he's a person who is very expect a lot of things. Okay, so he I'm also seeing that he's actually a big emperor. That means he expect a lot of things also. You know, he's always detecting people and tell people what to do. Okay, so in this aspect, we can also see that he can be a gossiper. He can create problem in basing on the symbol inside. All right, so if I were to see this kui itself, kui stand for water, it's a muddy water. So in this case itself, everything is seems so muddy. So general feel is that something is just not right. Okay, so we need to dig further into this chart itself and see why and how this is happening. Okay, next in business, we always talk about profitability. Profitability means we have a life. Life called the Shenmen. Shenmen is over here. Okay, so the sentiment itself accompanied with a white tiger, and we have this impulse. So white tiger meaning that if this profitability is going to be very fierce, very a lot of money to be made. But of course, in this aspect, there could be a rush to do certain things. So that's something we need to be very careful about. So in the profitability sign in within box number eight itself, it's going to tell us that yes, making money is possible, making profit is possible. So we look further and we look at some of the danger sign. Danger sign mean that this is the black tortoise. Black tortoise is a symbol of losing money. So losing money is accompanied with an injury, meaning that there's losing money, but there will be some moderate in that aspect. There will be some money to be lost. Okay, next. We have this bandit. Bandit meaning that there's big money loss. So big money loss is with the openness, meaning that it's not really that bad. It's actually with a very auspicious door. So technically it's not really that bad. So next, we look at the monetary itself, monetary over here. Okay, so this stands for Wu. Wu stands for money. That means the capital involved to invest in this particular venture. So in this venture, we have this money, we have this circle, we call it emptiness. Emptiness meaning that the capital involved is, she may not have the capital involved. So how do we verify this? Is this under this itself, we have this meta environment. Because over here, this is something related to gray color equates to meta. So herself is water. No, sorry, is fire. So in this aspect, fire actually clash with meta, meaning that herself is not supporting the monetary. So it's directly telling us that she does not have the money to begin with. Okay, next. We also need to check how reliable this venture is going to be. So reliability, we look at the view. The same box as box number 9, view is equates to the information provided by the person. Because Marcus want to invest in the retail shop. So this retail shop that provided information, how reliable it is. So we can see that there's a 9 heaven. 9 heaven means that it's a big line. So I may suspect that this particular investment itself, there's a lot of details and there's a lot of big details that is hidden and Mr. Marcus may not know. So Mr. Marcus may not have the capital involved also. Although the profitability may be a lot, there'll be some money loss, not big money. So that means this impulse itself in Chinese is called Tian Chong. Chong also means wash away, meaning that if you talk about profitability, the profitability is going to be washed away. So in that aspect, I would not expect the profitability to be high. And even if there's money to be made, it will somehow go to somewhere else. Okay, so in this case itself for Mr. Marcus, we will not recommend him to go into this particular venture. First of all, there's a lot of hidden details that we need to take care of. And if the problem itself is going to be super big. Okay, and the information provider are not so real. So I'm not too optimistic about this case study itself. So, all right, so this is how we decipher the information about this Qimen Dunjia. My name is Dr. Chan. Thank you for watching. Please continue with the other videos.